So now it was down to Gillingham, who brought the worst away record in the Football League to Buckinghamshire. Even a point would send Hartlepool down, and the nerves would surely have been jangling for some 2,000 travelling Gills fans when Matt Phillips curled in a beauty in first-half stoppage time to give already relegated Wickham a deserved lead. The disappointing Gills didn't offer much, submitting rather tamely to the football fates. A brief spell of pressure in the second half carved out a chance for Simeon Jackson, and if he'd done better, who knows what might have happened. And when Wickham defender Alan Bennett did do rather better, nodding home at the far post midway through the second half, Gillingham's destiny was out of their hands. A deflected goal from Kevin Betsy 8 minutes later really rubbed it in, but results from elsewhere shouldn't have mattered. Mark Stimson's men were the architects of their own doom.
That's it now, you know, we've got a horrible summer to not look forward to get over, and we'll see what happens.
What do you make of the reaction of the fans towards the end of the game there? They seem pretty hostile towards you and the players.
Yeah, I totally understand that, and if I was a paying supporter today, I would have probably been the same.
Yeah, bitterly disappointing day for Gillingham. I suppose it's hardly surprising considering, well, it's been their away form that's ultimately let them down.
And one all year. I mean, it's, as you say, I mean, six draws hardly gives you a chance to stand up. I mean, you can't rely on your home form, albeit that's been very good. But to lose 3-0 when, you know, your season is on that game, you need to get something. You're in the driving seat. You get something from the game and you stay up. To get beat 3-0 by a team that have already been relegated speaks volumes. And he showed he was disappointed there. There won't be many players left there next year if he's still in charge.
Well, Simeon Jackson, you can't see him sticking around, no, maybe. No, as for